In the previous video, we already have created our first module in Java. Now we are all set to create more than one modules and learn about handling intermodule dependencies. Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the session 8 of Java and Web, Modular Programming in Java. We can create more than one modules, where one module can use other modules. Here I am considering Linux directory structure, but same is true for Windows directory structure. Here you can consider as C drive, users, GAN, desktop, src. Here in the src directory of desktop, we want to create source code for two modules. Name of the one module is MyModuleA and name of other module is MyModuleB. Inside the directory MyModuleA, we have a package directory MyPackA. Inside the package directory, we have m1.java and there is other file in the MyModuleA directory, that is moduleinfo.java. Similarly, in the directory MyModuleB, we have a package directory MyPackB and inside the package directory MyPackB, we have m2.java. We have another file in the directory MyModuleB and that is moduleinfo.java. Let's see the Java file m2.java. The package statement of m2.java is package MyPackB. That's why the class created because of compilation of m2.java will be stored into the directory MyPackB. m2.java contains a public class m2, which contains a method abcd. The method abcd prints the string MyModuleB, MyPackB, m2. Now let's see the another Java file m1.java. m1.java contains the package statement package MyPackA. That's how the class file created because of compilation of m1.java will be stored into the package MyPackA. m1.java imports the class m2, which is inside the package MyPackB. And we know that the package MyPackB is in another module, that is the module MyModuleB. The Java file m1.java contains a public class m1. Class m1 contains the method main, which can be executed by the JVM. Inside the method main, we have created an object of class m2. And then we are calling the method abcd on an object whose address is stored into the reference variable m. Since m1.java is using m2.java and both are in different modules, so we have to write some codes in corresponding moduleinfo.java files. The moduleinfo.java of the module MyModuleA contains a code requires MyModuleB. By writing here requires MyModuleB, actually the module MyModuleA is saying that he wants to use some features of the module MyModuleB. Then the moduleinfo.java of MyModuleB exports the package MyPackB. Since the module MyModuleB exporting the package MyPackB, so the module which requires the MyModuleB can use the MyPackB. If the module MyModuleB do not export the package MyPackB, then even if the class inside the package MyPackB is public, then also other modules cannot use that class. That's how even if the class m2.java is public, but if the corresponding module do not export its package, then other modules cannot use it. That's how even if the class m2 in m2.java is public, but if the module MyModuleB do not export the package MyPackB, then other modules cannot use the class m2. Let's check this directory structure practically. On the desktop, this is our src directory. Go inside src. And we have two module directories, MyModuleA and MyModuleB. Let's go inside MyModuleA. We have the package directory MyPackA and the Java file moduleinfo.java. Let's open moduleinfo.java. This is the code of moduleinfo.java of the module MyModuleA. Module space, the module name MyModuleA. Then it requires MyModuleB. Whatever package is exported by the module MyModuleB, the MyModuleA requires all those packages. Cut it. Go inside the package directory MyPackA. Inside MyPackA, we have m1.java. Let's open m1.java. And this is same code as we seen. Let's come back in the directory src and go to the module directory MyModuleB. Inside MyModuleB, we have moduleinfo.java and the package directory MyPackB. Let's open moduleinfo.java. This is the code of moduleinfo.java in the module MyModuleB. Module space, the module name MyModuleB. Then MyModuleB exports the package MyPackB. If the module MyModuleB do not export the package MyPackB, then other modules cannot use the class m2. Cut it. Go in the package directory MyPackB. Inside MyPackB, we have m2.java. Let's open it. and this is the same code as we seen. A module can only export packages. A module cannot export the classes. Now we are all set with source codes of two modules. Let's compile our module. To compile both modules together, we need to execute the javac commands. The command javac followed by dash dash module source path. We need to write like dash dash module dash source dash path next to the option module source path. We need to give the full or relative path name of that directory which contains the source code of modules. Here only one directory src contains source codes of both modules which we want to compile. Src is the relative path name because we are considering the directory desktop as our current directory. Then after we need to use the option D. Followed by option D, we need to name that directory where we want to store our compiled modules. So a directory whose name is out will be created in the current directory which will contain the compiled code of two modules. Then after we need to use the option M. M means modules. Followed by the option M, we need to write names of the modules separated by the comma. After compilation of this code, a directory whose name is out will be created on the desktop because we consider the desktop as our current directory. Inside the directory out, we have compiled codes of two modules, my module A and my module B. Now let us try this command practically. Type javac space dash dash module dash source dash path space src space dash d space out space dash m space my module A comma my module B. Press enter. It compiles fine. You should not give the space between comma and the module name. Otherwise the compiler will throw an error. The class name my module B are only accepted if annotation processing is explicitly requested. Let's check practically if the source codes of two modules have been compiled or not. On the desktop, now we have the directory out. Go inside the directory out. And we have two directories, my module A and my module B. Inside the directory my module A, we have the class file moduleinfo.class. And we have a package directory mypack A. Go inside the package directory mypack A. We have the class file m1.class. Now let's go inside the module directory my module B. My module B also contains moduleinfo.class. Let's go inside the package directory mypack B, which contains m2.class. One thing you should remember that you should not write a module name which is ending with digit. If you write a module name which is ending with digit, then the compiler will generate a warning. This is not a good coding practice to write a module whose name is ending with a digit. We are all done with compilation of our module source code and we got the compiled module. Now we are all set to run our module. We know that the class m1 contains the method main and the class m1 is ultimately using the class m2 and calling the method abcd of the class m2. Finally, the method abcd of the class m2 is printing the output string. Let's execute the java command to run our compiled modules. Java space dash dash module dash path. Followed by the option module path, we need to write the full or relative path name of that directory which contains our compiled modules. Then we need to use the option m. Followed by the option m, we need to write the module name, that is my module A, forward slash. Then after we need to use here the fully qualified name of the class m1, that is mypack a.m1. When this command execute, it prints my module B, mypack B, m2. Let's execute this command practically. Java space dash dash module dash path space out space dash m space module A forward slash mypack A dot m1. Press enter. It executes fine in printing my module B, mypack B, m2. Even if the class m2 is public in its package mypack B, but if the module my module B does not export the package mypack B, then outside of the module my module B, no one can use m2. Let's try this. Go in the source directory of the module my module B. But before, let me delete the directory out. Now go in the source directory of the module MyModule B. Open moduleinfo.java and comment out this statement. The statement exports mypack B. Save it. Now let's try to compile both modules once again. The Java C command. Press enter. It throws an error. Package mypack B is not visible. In the m1.java, we have error in this statement. Import mypackb.m2. Package mypackb is declared in module mymodule B, which does not export it. So even if the class m2 is public, but other modules cannot use the class m2. This is the overall structure of our two modules. The module mymodule A in its moduleinfo.java requires the mymodule B. And the module mymodule A contains a package mypack A, which contains m1.class. And the module mymodule B exports the package mypackb in its moduleinfo.java and contains a package mypackb which ultimately contains the class m2. A module cannot export a class. Let me try it. Let the module mymodule B to export the class m2 and check what the compiler is saying. Type here exports mypackb.m2. Save it. Now compile it. First error it is saying package mypackb is not visible because the class m1 is still trying to use the package mypackb. And this is the error because we exported the class m2 instead of exporting the package. Here the Java C is not considering the m2 as class from the package mypackb. The Java C is considering mypackb.m2 as a package and saying package is empty or does not exist. And the package name is mypackb.m2. Let's correct this error. Delete .m2 from here. Save it. After compilation, if I store two modules in two different directories, then I will have to use a special option with Java command, that is upgrade module path. Here I have saved the compiled code of the module mymodule A in the directory out and saved the compiled code of the module mymodule B in the directory out too. Now we need to execute the Java command so that two modules stored in two different directories are used by the Java command. Execute the command java --upgrade module path. Next to the option upgrade module path, we need to give full or relative path names of two directories which contains compiled code of two modules. Then after we need to write the option m, followed by the option m, we need to write the module name mymodule A --, then fully qualified name of the class m1, that is mypackA.m1. Because the class m1 contains the method main. Let us try this practically. I have only one directory src present on the desktop. First, let us compile our both modules and store in the directory out. Clear the screen and execute the Java C command. Press enter. It compiles fine and we have the directory out on the desktop. Now create another directory on the desktop with a name out2. Right click, create new folder, name it out2. Go in the out directory, cut the module file mymodule B and go in the directory out2, paste it here. Now you can see the directory out contains the compiled module mymodule A and the directory out2 contains the compiled module mymodule B. Now let's execute these two modules together. If the compiled code of both modules are stored in different directories, type java --upgrade --module --path --out:out2. The two directories containing compiled code of two modules should be separated by colon. --m --mymodule A --mypackA.m1. Press enter. It executes fine and printing mymodule B, mypackb, m2. If the source code of two modules are stored in two different directories, then how we can compile these two modules together? For that, we need to execute Java C command with the option module source path. Then after, we need to give the full or relative path names of source codes of two modules which are stored in different directories. And these path names should be separated by colon. Then use D option. Here both compiled modules will be stored in the same directory out. Followed by the option M, we need to provide the module names separated by comma. Execute this command and it will create the directory out on the desktop. Because our current directory is desktop, the directory out contains the compiled codes of two modules. Let me try this practically. Delete these two directories, out and out2, and create a new directory, src2. Go in the directory src, cut the source code of the module, my module B, and paste it in the directory src2. Now the directory src contains the source code of the module, my module A, and the directory src2 contains the source code of the module, my module B. Let's compile these two source codes. Type the command java c space dash dash module dash source dash path space src colon src2 space dash d out space dash m my module a comma my module b. Press enter. It compiles fine, and on the desktop you can see the directory out has been created. We can execute the compiled modules in the directory out. We need to remove the directory name out2 from the Java command. Press enter. Executes fine and printing my module b, my pack b, m2.